in particular at the time of adhan and at the time of rain. And if we look at those two times, in particular adhan, you know you're supposed to repeat after the adhan. And then you make a dua for Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam at the end of the adhan. What was the dua again? اللهم رب هذه الدعوة التامة والصلاة القائمة آتي محمد الوسيلة والفضيلة وابعثه مقاما محمودا الذي وعدته. You do that, you're guaranteeing what? Intercession. شفاعة يوم القيامة. You make dua for yourself at the time of adhan also, any dua, it is accepted. Intercession is a major thing. It's not a joke. It's something big. For just saying that dua, to give that intercession, is something big. But then again, I was telling the students to control yourself just when we listen to the adhan, to repeat after that and see how hard it is. Extremely hard. If you can control yourself, whatever you do, and stop and listen to the adhan and repeat after him, which probably about 4 or 5 minutes, you will find out that it is extremely hard, even though it sounds simple thing. But to control yourself at that time and say it, not only one time hard, but I mean if you were to do it every time you hear the adhan, it's really hard. And that's why, just like when we mentioned before the dua, when you go to the mall or go shopping, you make that dua, it's simple dua, you get like a million hasana and million bad deed erased and all that, but who remembers it? And who is steadfast on it? Very few. Same thing when you see the rain. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, من أحب أن يستجيب الله له في الكرب والمصائب فليدعو الله في الرخاء. Anyone who likes to get his problem solved or his dua accepted at the time of problems and calamities, then make dua when you are not having problems and calamities. Because that's the criteria that you are connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Almost everyone at time of problems make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because you have no other choice. You lost it from everywhere. So we leave Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala till the end. After we exhaust everything by the human being, we go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When it's supposed to be the beginning to go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. Rain, when you see rain, some people hate it and some people like it. Those people who hate it, they don't know exactly what good they're missing. And those people who like it don't do what they're supposed to do, which is the dua. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, at time of rain, he used to show part of his body for the rain. So the rain would touch his skin. He said, إِنَّهُ حَدِيثُ عَهْدٍ بِرَبِّهِ. يعني he is coming from the sky. He is not far away, or just came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's company. You know, you feel like someone just came from Hajj. You ask him for, make dua. Someone just saw someone important, very close. Because the rain is coming from the sky. And what is coming from the sky with the rain? What is the rain? وَهُوَ الَّذِي يُرْسِلُ الرِّيَاحَ مُبَشِّرَاتِ. Rain is rahmah. Rain is rahmah. Generally, when the rain comes, mercy comes with it, because وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. Nothing lives without water. So you make a dua at that time, instead of covering yourself and running and it's raining, or complaining or feeling happy but not knowing what to do. And that is something that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam pointed our attention. Tintani la turaddan. الدعاء عند النداء والدعاء عند نزول المطر. Make sure you remember the dua when the adhan comes, and control yourself and see how hard is it when you hear the adhan. If you are sitting with a friend chatting, stop chatting for 5 minutes and repeat after the adhan. You will understand why you deserve the intercession, because usually the reward is proportional to the act. This is a small act, it seems like it, and a big reward. But when you start doing the act, you find out that it's not really that small. Small in action, but the control, the patience that you have to have is really big, and it gets on your nerves. Why? Because you're talking, or you're working, or you're doing something, and you need to just stop and wait. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. And you know, if you have one of those extremely adhan that takes a while, and you need to wait for everyone so quietly and silently until he says it, and then you say it after that, and you wait for another one, your mind is going, when is he going to finish? Yes. And I'm sure you do it, you don't have no problem. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك.